Each patient's going to be a little different when you approach them and you see necrotic tissue or slough in the wound. If I think the patient is going to benefit from having that tissue removed and there's no contraindications, such as being on anticoagulant medication that might lead to bleeding, I also want to make sure that pain control is adequate in that patient. I don't want to hurt them by taking off that dead tissue. I want to make sure that I think they've got adequate blood supply to heal that area. In those kind of patients, we will go ahead and sharply debride either with a knife or with a curette or with scissors and forceps. And then if there's any tissue left behind that needs to be debrided, we can apply certain topical agents that will help dissolve. And when I come back the next week, hopefully we're looking at less dead tissue and looking at more healthy tissue, and then we can start trying to stimulate that wound to grow. Enzymatic debriding agents will work, but they take a lot longer. They don't work nearly as fast as the sharp debridement does. And the longer you leave dead tissue in the wound, dead tissue releases chemicals that actually impede healing. Dead tissue is a fertile ground for bacteria to grow in, which if you do get infected, it's going to slow healing down. So by cleaning up and removing that, you stimulate the wound to lay down healthier tissue. Plus, when you do get just a tiny amount of bleeding in the wound, the platelets release platelet-derived growth factors into the wound, which stimulate it to grow. Removing the dead tissue, any dead tissue in that wound, is going to be an impediment to healing. Basically, when you debride it, you're getting the bulk of it out, and then I like to use the chemical agents to kind of clean up what's left behind.